Security.
Ngodi tukupat.
We also acknowledge the presence of the chief.
Di mbona uba hone ma wose ashu.
We are humbled by his honor.
Yeah. Kuto di faro nyaza manda uba hone abo.
To come and grace this occasion.
Uba diva hone zne rakita zone ka uka umshumo.
We wish that God should bless you, sir.
Yeah. Rekotama ungari mzimu na wajala patuchete kuwane.
In the gospel, we have a social responsibility. As the government does, out of these young children and youth, to make responsible citizens who will love their country, protect it, and make it prosper. We thank God for the gospel. But the gospel is a tool to do exactly that. And sometimes beyond. We have a wonderful session this morning. We have spent 6 hours less than
200 hours.
When I was counting the hours that we've spent here, from Saturday evening to yesterday evening, it was 192 hours. With the few hours that we're going to spend here today, it might just be less than
200.
That's a lot of time.
Yeah.
And I want to believe that you young people, you have not died. Your fingers are still with you. They are not numb from chatting and texting and all that. At least for a change, your fingers have rested. It's a lot of hours that we have given those beautiful fingers some rest. Hallelujah. We don't have a luxury of time today. Let's go to verse 13. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 13. These all died in faith, not having received the promises, but having seen them afar off, and were persuaded of them, and embraced them, and confessed that they were strangers and pilgrims on earth.
Vendor Bible.
Verse 11, 13.
They believed that there's a better country. There's a better way of living. They were strangers in the world and are pilgrims. And the theme of our camp meeting, our youth rally, the gospel youth pilgrimage. We are pilgrims on this world.
Yes.
Whether we like it or not,
yeah.
One day we are going to leave this world,
yes,
and go to a better one.
Yeah.
That God has created himself. No mankind has set up that planet. God himself,
yes,
the eye The ear has not heard. The eye has not seen. The good things that God has stored for those who love Him. What we see in this world, the confusion, the filth, the death, the crime, but there's a better world. There are better things that God has stored for you. There's a better future if the Lord tarries. If Christ tarries to come, God has stored for you, my young children, better things than the eyes see. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's go to Mark chapter 8.
Gospels.
The Gospel of Mark chapter 8. Yeah. Our topic for this morning. Killing self to follow Jesus.
Amen.
Killing self to follow Jesus. It is your responsibility that you should kill this body in order to be able to follow the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Chapter 8, verse 34.
Amen.
We are rushing. Amen.
Arali mutu achifuna utsara murao ngati yangwe
yes
awali chipambano chawe anzevere.
Hallelujah.
Verse 35 afuna utonda kuchiro hawe udobulobisa arobisa kuchiro hawe achitela ne na mapungo madipa udobuwani.
Amen. Zulu Bible 34 and 35.
Wabiza abantu nabafundi bakhe wathi kubo, othanda ukungilandela akazidele athabathe isiphambano sakhe angilandele. Ngokuba othanda ukusindisa ukuphila kwakhe wokulahlekelwa, kodwa olahlekelwa ukuphila kwakhe ngenxa yami nevangeli wokusindisa.
Azidele.
Deny
yourself. Forget who you are. Deny yourself for the sake of the cross. Just for the sake of the cross.
Amen.
If you want to live comfortably in this world and be part of all that you see surrounding you and partake thereof with all the parties that you see, with all the jamming that is done by young people of your age, and the Bible is saying this morning, deny yourself. Live as if those things do not exist.
Amen.
It's your own responsibility. Mfundisi won't do that for you. Mfundisi is not at the university where you are.
Mfundisi
is not at the school where you are. It is your responsibility to deny yourself.
Lord God.
Amen.
Distance yourself from the things that I've just mentioned. It is your responsibility. Can you see that I'm standing here at the pulpit? If I want to avoid this pulpit, I move backward. Move backward from the things of this world.
Yes.
God has blessed you in this rally. God has blessed me too. Some of us as ministers,
we shed
tears here when you were singing. The testimonies that you made touched our hearts. We were blessed. Don't disappoint us. Don't disappoint the cross. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Take the flag of the gospel high. Go out there. Distance yourself from the world. And say, my friend, I am now a child of God. Say to your classmates, I am now a child of God. I am now sanctified. I have a city that I'm looking up to. I don't hate you. I don't see myself as a holier than thou. But sorry, my friend. For now, sorry. I am saved. I am a child of God. Hallelujah. That's the message I want you to go with. With those few words, that's the message I want you to take home. Go to that community. Go to those friends. Tell them, I am now saved. I'm not a member of the apostolic faith. I'm not a member of CYC. I am now a child of God. I am now saved. Stand up. Stand up and be counted. In closing, I remember what Martin Luther King said. He said, I have a dream. I have a dream. Have that dream as well. Have that dream of winning that class. Have a dream to win those classmates in that lecture hall. Have a dream to win that lecturer who is using his status. To sleep with half of the girls that are in your class. Have a dream to win him. To win him. When he looks at you, when he looks at you as a young girl, as a gospel girl, he must see Jesus. He must see a difference. He must see a difference from a church goer. He might see